so glad to see everybody. thy name. Oh, yes. Oh Lord, thy kingdom come.
Yes.
Oh Lord, let thine will be done.
Oh yes.
Oh Lord, on earth you would have it done in heaven.
Yes, Lord.
Oh Lord, give us this day our Father. Mm-hmm. Oh Lord, in our daily we pray.
Yes.
Oh Lord, and forgive us for our debts, our Father. Oh Lord, as we forgive our debtors.
Yes.
Oh Lord, lead us not in the ways to temptation.
Yes, God.
Oh, our Heavenly Father, but deliver from all things which are sin and evil.
Yes,
Father. Oh Lord, but thy is the kingdom, our Father.
Mm-hmm.
Oh Lord, all power and glory do hold in your own hand.
Yes, God.
Oh Lord, it's once more time and again, my Father.
Yes.
You have allowed your humble servant to bow down before you this morning.
Yes.
Oh Lord, just to tell you, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh Lord, for one more day's journey.
Yes.
Oh Lord, I want to thank you, my Heavenly Father.
Yes, God.
Oh Lord, for your darling angel. You watched over me all night long while I slumbered and while I slept.
Yes,
Father. Oh Lord, and then we heard it this morning, my Father. Yes. Tell me with your divine faithful love.
Yes.
Woke you up to see another brand new day.
Yes, Lord.
Oh Lord, I want to tell you thank you,
thank you
this
Lord.
Morning. Oh Lord, for one more sunny day.
Mm-hmm.
Oh Lord, I want to ask you this morning, my Father. Oh Lord, to create in me a clean heart this morning.
Yes.
Oh Lord, restore this right spirit within me.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh Lord, let me be able to love this morning. Mm-hmm. Oh Lord, as you so loved us. Mm-hmm. Oh Jesus, this morning.
Yes.
I'm calling you this morning, my Father. Why, kind is another blessing, my Father.
Yes.
Oh, to still be alive this morning.
Mm-hmm.
For I rely on my Father, many, many thousands have died and gone on, my Father.
Yes.
Oh, Lord, and it breaks my heart this morning.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Lord, my Father.
Yes.
I want to tell you thank you,
thank you
my Father,
you,
for allowing my golden morn to roll on just a little while longer, my Father. I hadn't done anything so well,
yes.
Nor had I deserved it, my Father.
Mm-hmm.
But all your grace
Lord,
and your divine mercy this morning,
yes.
Smile on me one more time, Lord.
Yes.
And I want to tell you thank you for it.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, somebody's morning, Lord. A heart is aching this morning, my Father. Got trouble in their home,
yes.
And sadness in their heart this morning, my Father. But I realize this morning, my Father.
Yes.
You said the trouble coming in the morning, my Father.
Yes.
And you were able, my
yes.
Father, to give joy to a sorrow heart this morning.
Yes,
I want to tell you thank you this morning.
Bless
their home this morning.
Yes,
they're sitting inside of my weak heart this morning.
Yes.
Somebody needs you for one day. Somebody needs you for another.
Yes.
But I'm so glad this morning, my Father, according to your word, my Father, you are able.
Oh, yes.
Oh, I need my Father, according to your riches and glory. I want to tell you thank you.
Thank you.
I want to tell you thank you.
Thank you.
I'm able to this morning, my Father, tell you thank you one more time.
Oh, yes.
Oh Lord, call my Mary baby this morning,
yes.
My lady of the valley, my bright and my morning star,
Lord.
My bread of life.
Yes.
Living water this morning.
Yes.
Sure do thank you this morning. Oh, Lord, one of these old days, my Father.
Yes.
Friend, today's going to be over down here. You're going to call all our name, my Father.
Yes.
One of these old days, we got to come down before a judgment, Father,
yes.
And answer to you, my Father.
Yes.
But whatever it be, my Father, we pray with me. You meet with someone to dine out.
Yes.
Lord, receive our soul in your kingdom. We be evermore to give you praise and glory. Tell you thank you.
Thank you,
thank you for standing one more opportunity.
Yes.
Then, Lord, when your time to call, then I'll time to answer.
Mm-hmm.
We are so in the dying hour.
Yes,
he's all favors and blessed with you, pray. That's your name for Christ's sake. Amen. We thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Lord. I'm satisfied with Jesus. I'm satisfied with Jesus. I'm satisfied with Jesus in my heart. Well, I'm satisfied with Jesus. I'm satisfied with Jesus. I'm satisfied with Jesus in my heart.
Seen and unseen. When I didn't know where I was or what I was doing, I wasn't capable of looking out for myself.
Amen.
But God had to step in.
Amen.
He wiped the taste of alcohol out of my mouth and I hadn't looked back.
Amen.
Since 21 years.
Glory.
And everybody look around and say, I go around it, it don't bother me. I was around for a little while yesterday while I was doing some work. You don't drink? No, I don't drink. And I thank God for it. That's a chance to give my testimony right then on the spot. And
Amen.
I thank God for it right now because he's been so good to us. Been better to us than we've been.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
To ourselves.
Amen. Amen.
We'd like to thank him and give him praise and uplift his name. I'm so glad to see people out here.
Yay.
Because God is powerful over everything. I mean, everything on this world, he's over it. He got the power over it. He got the power over the coronavirus. But people been looking for the wrong answers, going to the wrong places, continuing to catch it and die, passing by God's house, all in the process.
Hello.
This is where the prayer is supposed to be made at.
Come on.
He hears when we come together. Some things we can do, and we can do it in safety. Wear your mask, space out. We got sanitizer here at the church. We got everything that you need according to the guidelines of the CDC. Everything that you need. But sometimes you got to stand up for God.
Glory.
Don't step back on him and take a back seat. Because guess what he's going to do? He's going to take a back seat on the people.
Amen.
That's what happened. You took a back seat on it. Okay, let the virus run wild. Don't nobody want to recognize me. They want to stay in their homes, in their comfort, which is, that's what they were saying do. But God's sick and tired of us. And this is when things happen like this. He gets sick and tired of things happening like this. How long is it going to take for my people who are called by my name to humble themselves and pray? How long is it going to take? You look back through the Bible, event after event, virus after virus, you know, whatever you want to call it, after virus, have came through the land. Ain't nobody stopped praising God, though.
Amen.
Amen.
Ain't nobody stop. God sent Moses to Pharaoh and told him to let his people go. He sent plagues then. But he had a protection for the people, for his people.
Come on.
He had a protection over his people.
Speak deep.
He really did. So we believe in the same God and got the same faith that we've been serving all along. When a virus come along, where's our faith?
Amen.
Have we laid it down to the side? We still have faith in God. He give us common sense too.
Amen.
How to continue praising him. He brought us, through the YouTube and everything,
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But we don't want to get too comfortable with that because God wants us to meet and come together.
Amen.
That's what his people are all about. He praises us when we come together like that. And God going to look out for us. They're going to look out for us. Everybody else be catching it and going everywhere else, but they ain't been to church. What you going to blame it on? You can't blame it on the church. But we still fail to do what's necessary. We got to do what's necessary. And God is watching us, and we got to be an example for the world to see. Sometimes, things ain't going to always go our way. Things going to come against us in this world. But don't lay your faith down and set it to the side. We got to keep moving.
Amen.
Got to keep moving.
Amen. History program this morning, and we're going to start off with our welcoming occasion by Destiny Mitchell.
I am black, I am beautiful, inside and out. I am black, I am beautiful. I'm filled with such pride. I am beautiful, I am black. I am black, I am beautiful. Welcome to our Black History program. As African Americans, we need to understand that we are beautiful people, and I hope we help you see it today.
Amen.
Amen. Next, we'll have a poem by Sister Makaya Washington.
Amen. If I were a rose painted black, would you cast me aside like black and burnt? Would you color, would my color tarnish my sweet smell? If I were a rose painted black, would the richness of my ebony petals make me unworthy of being called a rose? If I were a rose painted white, would my ivory petals be worth more than silver? Would my sweet smell captivate a room welcomely, if I were a rose, sweet smelling and vibrant, and your mind was blind, would my color matter?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Makaya. Next we'll have Brother Mark Robinson with another poem.
Amen.
Reading your national anthem by Clint Smith. Today, a black man who was once a black boy like you got down on one of his knees and laid his helmet on the grass as his country sang his ode to the promise he never kept. And the woman in the grocery store line in front of us is on the phone, and she is telling someone on the other line that this black man who was once a black boy like you should be grateful we live in a country where people aren't killed for things like this, you know. She says, in some places, they will hang you for such a blatant act of disrespect. Maybe he should go live there instead of here. so he can appreciate what he has. And then she turns around and sees you sitting in the grocery cart, surrounded by lettuce and yogurt and frozen chicken thighs. And you smile at her with your toothless gum smile, and she says that you are the cutest baby she has ever seen, and tells me how I must feel so lucky to have such a beautiful baby boy. And I thank her for her kind words, even though I should not thank her, because I know that you will not always be a black boy, but one day a black man. And you may decide your country hasn't kept its promise to you either. And the woman or another like her will forget you were ever this boy, and they will make you into something else and tell you to be grateful for what you've been given.
Amen. Next we'll have a reading by Sister Donadia Ross.
Funny how history and present day are so far apart yet so close. I can mold myself to be like Shirley Anita Chisholm. Chisholm, in 1968, became the first black woman elected to the United States Congress. In the 1972 United States presidential election, she became the first African American and woman candidate for a major party's nomination. Who would think an African American woman born 4 years before Chisholm became the first black woman elected to Congress is the highest ranking female in U.S. history today? Kamala Harris is living Shirley Chisholm's dream. History teaches us by prayer and faith, God will bring our dreams into fruition. I see two strong black women who, despite their race, wanted to be great and make a difference. Modeling myself to be a positive influence on the black community has already begun. Like Harris, I plan to graduate from a prestigious college like Howard University. Chisholm earned her Bachelor of Arts from Brooklyn College in 1946. Both Chisholm and Harris were influenced by their fathers in politics. Chisholm's father was an avid supporter of Marcus Garvey and a dedicated advocate of the rights of trade union members. Harris's father is a Stanford University professor emeritus of economics. Inspired by what they saw, they led them to become the great leaders we received. I am grateful for Chisholm and Harris being history made before my eyes. Thank you.
Next we'll have, well, first thank Donadia for that reading.
Amen.
If you give me just a moment to move a few things for our little ones. Okay, so we have a poem mashup by Sister Joy Robinson, Sister Ariana Simmons, and Sister Canaria Ross.
Chair. Do you know who you are? Do you know who you really are? Do you know who you can be? Who you try to be? Who you want to be? Who you can be?
Oh, man.
You may write me down in history with your bitter, twisted lies. You may trap me in the very dirt, but still, like dust, I'll rise.
Oh. Hey, but...
Huh? Hey, Black Tail. Do you know you are strong? I mean, really strong? Do you know you can do what you want to do if you try to do what you can do?
You may shoot me with your words. You may cut me with your eyes. You may kill me with your hatefulness, but still, like air, I'll rise, leaving behind nights of terror and fear. I rise into a daybreak that's wondrously clear. Bringing the gifts that my ancestors gave, I am the dream and the hope of the slave.
I rise.
I rise.
I rise.
Hey, hey. Ariana Simmons. Thank you, Ariana.
Amen.
Next, we'll have a blast from the past with our very own Miss Annabelle.
You know me. You know I'm getting old. I can't move like I used to. They give me a few minutes here. Don't laugh at me, children, because you got to get here one day. Chilling.
Oh, gracious Heavenly Father, be with them. Be with them families. Be with them, Lord.
Yes.
Give them the strength, Lord, that they need. And Lord, let this vaccine that they got, they giving shot one, shot two, be successful. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Y'all know this is a blast from the past. And we got to remember now, you older folk, they don't teach Black history in school. You know, just the other day, I was reading on that smartphone, you know, these smartphones they got. It said a school in Utah told the kids, the white kids, they didn't have to do Black history activities. Isn't that a shame at this day and time? You know, Frederick Douglass said some years ago, he said, until we have that ballot in our hand, we still slaves.
Amen.
But we got the ballot and we still slaves.
Amen.
The 13th Amendment said all men were created equal and we got the same right. But the white man knew what they were doing. They came back in 14 and said, you got to have land. You got to be able to raid. And you got to be educated. How are we going to be educated? And we're plowing the fields for so long. But that's okay. Because that man named Abraham Lincoln, you know, he read by the fire. Abraham Lincoln came along and he said, I'm going to abolish slavery. Well, you know, whites in the South, they're like that. Because the cotton and the tobacco and the sugar cane couldn't get pulled and picked. So they said, if he win, we're going to get our own government. So he won. And that's when that Civil War, you know what a Civil War is? Canara, yeah, you know what a Civil War is? Yes. What is a Civil War, girl?
Within,
that's right. That girl gets some education. She know what it is. So they had a Civil War. And the North won, you know. But South Carolina said, we gonna leave. They didn't just take the land and move, you know. But they seceded from the Union. But that slavery was still going on. But you go down there in Mobile, long after they said abolish slavery, they still were bringing the ship over in Mobile. Y'all need to visit African Town. They got a town down there in Mobile called Africa Town. You ain't got to go far. It just got all of everything, the history you need down there. Cujo can tell you about what happened. They got Cujo's story. You know, he was the last one survivor on the ship that lived to tell the story. Okay, I'm going to give y'all some history. Y'all see this ironing board right here?
Yes.
Y'all know y'all mom and dad iron y'all clothes on the ironing board, don't they? I bet you don't know who invented that ironing board. Her name was Sarah Boone. She's a Black woman. She invented this ironing board. You know what I'm talking about? And then you got this mailbox. It may not look like your mailbox at home, but this mailbox was invented by Philip Downing. So we didn't have this mailbox, our mail be laying on the ground somewhere getting wet. Y'all know what I'm talking about, children? Okay. And then you know, Madam C.J. Walker, self-made millionaire. She made that grease. I ain't talking about that grease you cook with. I know that grease go in your hair, make your hair look good. Them hard up and that straightened comb. You know, we had nappy hair. We had nappy hair. Go back, children. Go back, little girl. Ooh, ooh. Always, little children, always trying to get in the way of old folks. You got to respect the old folks. Don't get in my way. Okay. And that lawnmower, they wake you up at 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock in the morning on Saturday when you're trying to sleep. You know, my old lady, I be trying to get my sleep. Well, John Brewer invented that lawnmower.
Amen.
All right. Thank God for God grabbing me on top of the house. All right. Y'all see this mop here? Ain't the mop your mama mop with. But then my grandbaby mop. But you know what? The mop was invented by a Black man, Thomas Stewart. And you couldn't even use a pencil sharpener because it was invented by a Black man. You know, if we didn't have these things, we'd be lost. We'd be like the little boy Theo that mama told him, let's go shopping. And she named all the things, and then she told him they weren't available for him. And you know, that just kept on going. Hey, Aaron, you know that man that swung that bat, hit that ball, broke who record? Who record he broke? Babe Ruth record, a Black man. He got a stadium down there in Mobile, chillin', named after him. Go down there and visit sometime. He recently passed. Mm-hmm. But before he passed, he made his mark and history. Mm-hmm. Y'all don't know that history. What your history gonna be? Mm-hmm. What you gonna be? You gonna be the next pilot, the next doctor, the next lawyer? What your history gonna be when I can get up here and talk about you? And then Josetta, Matthew, Pastor Stokes, you probably know her. She from down there in English Village, close to South Lawn. She was the first African American to graduate from Auburn University. Mm-hmm. That's right, Wall Eagle.
Amen.
We ain't rolling no ties up here today. We talking about Wall Eagles. Josetta was the first African American instructor. So her daughter called me yesterday. Oh, what's it, yesterday? It might have been 2 weeks ago. You know I'm getting that kind of memory law, lapse of memory. But she called and said, they're going to start a scholarship in her name. A little old black woman, Dr. Josetta Matthew, down there from English Village, down the road down there. And then they're going to name a building after her.
Amen.
George Foreman ain't, not George Foreman, what that man name? Y'all know that man, he put the head, name down on the neck. What his name was? George Floyd. George, he dying, Bane. Look at the changes being made. God got a purpose for everything.
Amen.
He know what he's doing. And then you got Wilma Rudolph. My mama had 22 children. I don't know about one woman, but it was 22 siblings. And she was number 21. She got polio, you know, in the leg, and she couldn't move her legs and stuff, and the doctors thought she'd never walk or run again. That little girl, Ariana, told her about her. She said, Wilma Rudolph won 3 gold medals. Not one, 3 gold medals. Running, track, fastest woman in the world during her time. We got some history, boys and girls. Y'all better read about that history. Hey, black child. That's what they said up in the day. Hey, black child, do you know who you are? Do you know who you really are? Do you know you're strong and you can do anything you want to do? Believe in yourself.
Amen.
Believe in yourself. I think I'm gonna get through with this, you know, and I got my memory, you know, so Lord Ray. And being a dust painter, you know, when you sweep the dust up on, used to use cardboard. You use a new paper. Somebody, amen?
Amen.
Okay, now we got the dust painter by a black man. All right. I know, though, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to close off here. I done told you everything, I think, a little bit to get you curious about something. But no, I was on that smartphone the other day. You got a smartphone here, man? Let me see smartphone. I was on that smartphone. I don't know how to use it that much. My grandchildren, my daughter, had to tell me how to use it. But these smartphones, they're smarter than us. I was looking another day, and they said, Socrates. Raise your hand, you know who Socrates, you ever heard of Socrates? They said, Socrates might have been a black man. Now, you got to do a little more research, folks. He was over there acting grease. That ain't the grease you put in your hair. Ain't the grease you cook with. He's over there acting grease. They said he was a black man. He was a smart man, too. So we ain't got no dummies. Where are my next doctors in here? Raise your hand.
Amen.
What doctor you going to be?
Veterinarian.
Veterinarian. I'm going to take care of them animals. What you gonna be, Nadia? I guess I'll find it. You'll tell me, darling. You'll tell me what they and they do what? Are they doing it? Autopsy. Oh Lord, the girl wanna look at the diet and find out why what happened to him. That's good.
Amen.
That's good. What my teacher said? Oh, little John wanna be a teacher. You'll be a cute little teacher, girl. You doggone good. You gonna be like Miss Annabelle.
Amen.
Annabelle. All right. What you gonna be, little girl?
A nurse.
A nurse. When you like waking up with seeing her standing over you.
Amen.
I hope she know how to get them shots.
Well, some of the teeth I can take care of.
Huh? Oh, your dentist too. All right, where my pilots? I ain't got no pilot. Where my professional football players? Where my professional football players? He gonna lay it to the side. He know who I'm talking to. Oh, so he go scooter back there, don't break his hand. Scooter, what you gonna be? He ain't decided yet, but the sky is the limit, Scooter. The sky is the limit. All right, I want y'all to sing this song. I'm going to close out. I want y'all to sing this song. I'm Mr. Man, and you can have your phone back. That's a smartphone there. Ooh, look at that. Got the spit seed again. Oh, boy, you eat something else. How much that thing cost? Huh? By $5. I want about 20 of them, leave. Give me 20 of your cell phone. That's a smart baby there. All right. I want y'all to join in with me, little children, not the grown-ups. I want the children to sing, "Dear Little Light of Mine." And then I'm going to get out your way. "Dear Little Light of Mine, I'm going to let it shine." Come on up here, children. "Dear Little Light of Mine." Come on, children. "I'm going to let it shine." Clap your hand, grown-up. "Dear Little Light of Mine." Come on up here, Winter. Come on, Winter. Come on, Winter. "Let it shine.
Sing a song full of the faith. Hallelujah. Lift every voice and sing.
Yes, Lord.
God is so good today.
Amen.
They call this Black History Month. Mm. But if I'm not mistaken, every day I wake up is Black History.
Amen.
It's a day that I can lift up God. It's a day that I can grow closer. It's a day that I can call out His name.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
We thank God for the children today and all who work with the children.
Amen.
And it's so beautiful to see them active in the church in this day and time. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. There are so many other things they can have their minds on. But to God be the glory. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. We won't tarry today much longer. We have had an awesome day thus far. We have a few platforms that we use here during this time. We're on YouTube. We're on Zoom. You can pay your tithe through the app called Tidely. It's on his YouTube page, but if you look up Tidely, you can look, also look up Mount Zion Primitive Baptist, and that way you can pay your tithe and offering. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. And if you don't like using a computer or your cell phone or your tablet, you can also come to the church physically from 12 to 1 each Sunday and pay your tithe and offering. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. There are also ways you can do it by mailing it in. So we have other options here that we can use that everybody's not ready to be in person, so we have to respect that. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. But we want to thank God for the children today, the program that has been put together, the program committee. We want to thank you. We want to thank the youth advisors who are doing an awesome job.
Amen.
With our children. Amen?
Amen.
So we want to give them a hand clap of praise. And it's not easy just hopping up in front of these cameras and in front of the church and reciting poems and acknowledging things that God has done within your spirit. So we want to say that we're thankful for that. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Tonight at 7 o'clock, we will be meeting again on Zoom because we will be coming together in prayer as we embark on a 21-day fast. So bring your petitions, bring your heart, bring your heaviness, or whatever it is that you might be beckoning for God to do for you in these 21 days, He's going to do it. He's going to meet you through the midst of this fast that we're about to do. Every day there should be something sent out through, I think it's a text messaging app that we have. There'll be a layout every day for 21 days that you'll be able to receive not only instruction on the day, but it'll have scripture with it as well, a prayer and scripture daily. So that way you can be reminded of why you're fasting and to be a strength throughout the fast. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Am I forgetting anything, First Lady? Am I forgetting anything in the announcements? I'm just glad that we're all here today for this opportunity. We have conference on next Saturday. So try your best to be there. It's going to be explosive. It's going to be good. And God's going to do great things. So Wednesday night, Sunday, Bible study. 7:15. Try to be there on Zoom. It's on the Zoom app. Same address you're using now. Use it for Bible study, Sunday school, and anything that we might be doing on Zoom unless otherwise instructed. Amen?
Amen.
I'm not going to tarry with the word today. There is a word today during this Black History celebration. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. The word will be taken from Romans chapter 5. And we're going to look at verses 18 through 21. That's Romans chapter 5, and we're going to look at verses 18 through 21. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. When you get it, stand for the reading. Romans chapter 5, verses 18 through 21. Amen, amen. We're not there yet. Say, wait, preacher.
Amen.
Amen. So we're there. And it reads as follows. Therefore, as through one man's offense, judgment came to all men, resulting in condemnation, even so through one man's righteous acts, the free gift came to all men, resulting in justification of life. For as many by one man's disobedience, many were made sinners, so also, by one man's obedience, many will be made righteous. Moreover, the law entered that the offense might be abound. And but wherefore sin abounded, grace abounded much more. So that it is sin reigned in death, even so grace might reign through righteousness to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Let us pray. Father God, we just thank you today for life and life more abundantly. We thank you for your Son who became the supreme sacrifice on our behalf. God, in the name of Jesus, stand here, God, as I stand in the name of Jesus. I ask that you would decrease my flesh and that you would inject your spirit man upon me, that I might be used for your mighty kingdom work, God. Faith without works is dead. So God, let me show both right now. That you will show up and show out in the name of Jesus. Let your Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide. Regulate, God, your people, that their minds will be prepared to let your word fall on fertile ground. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. 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 Being that this is the Black History Celebration, I wanted to be in context with the observation of what we're on, but there was a theme that still we rise. And I want to be close to it as I can, but I also want to be obedient to what the Holy Spirit is telling me. Amen? Amen. Scripture of the day was Proverbs 24:16, for a righteous man might fall 7 times and rise again, amen, but the wicked may fall by calamity. Topic today, if you're writing down topics or if you're taking notes, I just want to share this briefly with you, and I pray that it is something that can help your spirit. The topic today, the subject that I'll be preaching is from breaking away from those generational curses.
Amen.
And if you want to be bold enough, say, I am breaking away from those generational curses. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Generational curses. If I wanted to find a way to define generational curses, it'll be something that happened before me.
Amen.
It'll be something that happened of one of my loved ones, one of my relatives, someone that loved, something that happened along the line that brought me to where I am in this day and time. Amen. And when we find Paul here, he was trying to expound something to the Romans that curses were set up long before we got here.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen?
Curses were already abound in this land and in this world long before we got here. But if we go back in history and we start looking back at the story where the first curse came about, it came about through Adam. Uh-oh. We're talking about generations. If I look back on Jesus' generation, he walked on this earth 42 generations later. But we're going to go back a little bit further. We're going to go all the way back to the beginning. So when we're talking about Black history, we're talking about history. We're talking about history of the man, the Black man. We got to go all the way back to Adam.
Amen.
And that's what Paul was doing here in Romans. He was trying to tell us that it's time to break away from those generational curses. Those things that have so easily beset us for so many years. Amen. Do you think what you're going through today is just because of what you're doing?
Say it now.
No, it's not, because if we go a little further and we get in the book of Exodus, when God gave the Ten Commandments, he said, I visit the curses and I visit the iniquities of the third and fourth generation. So it ain't all about what you did, but today I stop by today to tell you it's time for us to put our foot down and stop these generational curses. They want to give you a 1 month of a year and tell you it's Black history. You want to say, well, I can't wait to February. What about every other month? There are 365 days in a year that is un-Black history. If you look in the mirror, you want to see some Black history, that is.
Amen.
Because when you leave here, there's going to be an epitaph on your burial tombstone. Yes. It's going to have your birth year, a dot, and it's going to have your death year. So if I'm looking for some Black history to be made, I'm making it right now.
Amen.
Black history has been made today when those children got up and spoke. Amen. Black history was made when Kim got up and emceed. Black history was spoken when Miss Annabelle came up and told y'all the history. Black history is made today. I am Black history.
Amen.
And Paul is trying to tell us how to convey what Adam did and what Christ came to do. See, we got to realize something. The curses stopped when Christ came.
All right.
But did you pick up on it? Did you pick up on what Christ came for? He didn't come for himself. He came for you and me. He came that we might have life and life more. But let's see what Paul said here. Paul said, therefore, as though one man's offense, judgment came to all men. That was a generational curse. There it is right there. Adam's sin messed us all up. If I can say it like that. First point I want us to know, as we try to break these generational curses, first thing we need to know is I'm not my father. I'm not my father. The things that he did, I can't do. The things that he messed up on, I want to get right. But it all starts with my relationship with Christ. Oh, my hand's free today. Thank God, First Lady. I can move a little bit and talk a little bit. Hallelujah. It all starts with me. It starts today. There are things I've been dealing with that came from my grandfather. There are things I've been dealing with that came from my great-grandfather. There are things I've been dealing with that my great-great-grandfather allowed to happen, and I'm not going to allow it to happen any longer. I got children that I need to be praying for. I got relatives that need to be healed. The hospital is full of COVID patients. The hospital is full of sick people. The curses got to stop today. I am not my father. If I read a little father in Bible study the other night, if I'm not mistaken, Leviticus chapter 27 tells you got to start praying for the things that your father did. Not just what you're doing, but you got to pray for the sins that your father committed. So I am not my father. I'm a product of my mother and father. But I am not what he did when I didn't see him. Many of us come from great fathers and great mothers, but they messed up too. And I'd be doggone if we go any further without us breaking these generational curses. Amen. This black history, what they put on with black history, they gave us Willie Lynch, who told all the slave owners. He had a meeting in Barbados. He said, if you ever let them get an inkling of who they truly are, we got a problem. Amen. Because they are the men and women of God. They are God's prized possession. Adolf Hitler said it in a letter, that if they ever know truly that they've been captive because of who they truly are spiritually. And you can kill the flesh, but the spirit, that's why Adolf Hitler went on a rampage against the Jews, because he said, these aren't real Jews, these are the fake Jews. The black people are the Jews. Check your history. I'm talking about black history. I'm talking about my history. I'm talking about me today. Make it personal. This is about you knowing that you are not your problem. You are not the curses that they put on you. You are not what the people say you are when you are greater than what they say. Yeah. But we see that. Paul was trying to get this thing lined up where you could understand that he said judgment came on all men because of one man's sin. So let me stop there for a minute. So by me not being my father, and I'm saying I'm putting my foot down for the things that happened in my past, what about my children? That means I need to be putting my foot down for my children too. And my children's children. I am not my father. So I'm breaking away from these generational curses. So what should I do to be able to break away knowing that I'm not my father? The second thing I want us to do is what? We need to reconnect with the Heavenly Father.
Yeah. Amen.
If I'm not my earthly father, I need to reconnect with God. Through his son, Jesus Christ, who bled the blood that I might have life. Who paid the blood when he died on the cross, when he hung down from that 6 to the 9. Now, I couldn't have did it. You couldn't have did it. Because you can't even help if you get a little boo-boo on your leg, you crying all day. But Paul, he was trying to get them to understand in Rome that even though we know the law, we haven't met Jesus yet. And now that we've met Jesus, let me take you a little deeper. So you have a full understanding that these generational curses that was brought about in the beginning, they won't hurt me in the long run. Even though we realize that God and Satan, they had a meeting and they talked about Job. You got to realize God and Satan, they have a meeting and they talk about you.
Amen.
So I got to reconnect with my Heavenly Father. But Paul went on to say this. He said, resulting in condemnation, even so through one man's righteous act, the free gift came to all men, resulting in justification. I've been justified because of Christ. he hung. I've been justified because he woke up. I've been justified because he got up. I've been justified because he sat at the right hand of God. What? No, I'm breaking away from these generational curses. I don't care what your mama did. I don't care what your auntie did. I don't care what they did. It has nothing to do with you and your relationship with God. It's your relationship. Connect right with your Heavenly Father for yourself and not for nobody else. Stop trying to show somebody you all this and that when you really torn down on the inside. So I'm going to say I'm breaking away from those generational curses. Things hurt me that I didn't even know was going on in my life. Things hurt me from way back when. Which brings me to my third point. The third point of all is simply impossible. I must be about my Father's business. What you mean? I must be about my Father. In order for me to break a generational curse, I must be about my Father's business. His business is way more important than mine. His business will take me higher than I ever thought I could go. His business will break me free from the things that subject me to this world. His business will take me a next place in my job. His business will take me higher in my spiritual aspect. His business will make my prayers be stronger and they go a little longer. His business will make me study his word and I fully understand what I mean. His business will make me float around sometimes when everybody's down and out. His business. Breaking away from those generational curses. But he said, I've been justified of life. But he went a little further in 19. He said, but as far by one man's disobedience, many were made sinners. So your mistakes that you're going through, it wasn't just about what you're doing. Even though you stuck in a rut, but it came before you. You ain't the first and you ain't going to be the last. Okay. See, what we got to realize is when you put your foot down and you surrender your life, right there, Christ changes you. He gives you the Holy Spirit. Now, here come the enemy because he got all that ammunition to use against you about what you used to be. If you notice something, you ain't going through what you are now. You're going through what you used to be. What you're going through now is the transformation that God is shifting some things in your atmosphere that when you look back over your life, yesterday going to be way better than what today, tomorrow going to be way better than what yesterday was, and your right now going to take you higher than you ever been. But if I read a little further, he said, now, also by one man's obedience, many be made righteous. By one man's sin, many paid a different price. But by one man's obedience. So if I say to myself, today is the day that I'm going to stop and put my foot down and things going to change in my life. By my obedience at that point, my children going to be changed. By my obedience at that point, my wife going to be changed. Oh, I'm going to be a little bolder today. By my obedience today, this church going to be shook up. By my obedience today, the people going to be set free. By my obedience, just like one man sinned and all fell, one man can be obedient and all come back together in Jesus. But we look a little further. In verse 20, he said, moreover, the law entered the offense might be abound. But where sin abounded, grace abounded much more. Y'all ain't get that. He said, well, sin abounded, grace abounded much more. So I'm about my Father's business now. You about your Father's business now. So grace is going to cover you. Grace is going to keep you. Even when you don't deserve it. And you try your best. You fight through the storm. You ain't let nothing stop you. You ain't let nobody criticize you to the point where you want to give up. Grace is going to carry you. Grace is sufficient to keep me from stumbling in the midst of what the world is trying to bring to me. See, we can't get caught up on what's going on out there. I got to start with the inside of me. These generational curses. Y'all, we can't even imagine from Adam all the way to where you are, how many curses are affecting your life now. How's it affecting your life now? That's Adam. That's the beginning. Think about your intermediate family members who've been dealing and dabbling in witchcraft, dealing and dabbling in sin. And then you were born into a world of sin. Where does that put you? Where does that put you? But he said, I'm breaking away from those generational curses. I no longer want to set no tone for a curse to continue over my children. I don't want to set a tone for a curse to continue over my loved ones. See, I'm not just praying for my family. I'm praying for everybody. I'm praying for the church to move. I'm praying for Corona to move. And in Jesus' name, it's going to move. It's going to move. In 2021, it's going to move. We need y'all to believe that it's going to move. Curses are going to be broken. In 2021, it's going to move. This is the year of the breakthrough. It's going to move. In Jesus' name. But he says this as I close. He said, not only did grace abound much more. He said, so that sin is reign and death. Even so, grace might reign through righteousness and eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. When I'm being about my Father's business,
come on.
A generation curse don't matter. What they did back then don't matter. See, that's one of the things that hinders us. I surrendered my life. I believe that Christ changed me. I believe that Christ set me free. Why am I still bound? Why should I be bound and Christ set me free? Why should I be bound and they unlocked him from the cross? Why should I be bound they had to take him down when they knew he was dead? Why should I be bound that they put him in a borrowed tomb? Why should I be bound? Because I know a man. I know a man that they couldn't hold in the tomb. I know a man, he did stay on that cross. I know a man who hung down from that seat to the ninth hour. I know a man who broke all generational curses. I know a man in the beginning, Adam failed, but Jesus came. I know a man that came to set me free. I know a man that hung out in that tomb. I know a man that for 3 days he preached. For 3 days he preached. For 3 days he preached. He went down in the hellfire, set loose the saint, let him loose, came back and walked the earth for 40 more days. I know a man that'll give you the strength to break all generational curses. But you got to believe in yourself. You can't believe on your mama's faith, but your mama's faith might be shaken too. You got to believe on the faith that God has given you when he supplies all your needs on a daily basis. Because I know a man that is able. He's able when all else is failed. He's able even in black history, which is my history. Can I get it said like that? You said this is me history. Everything is about me. We got to let it get personal, because if it's not personal, somebody else is stealing your joy. If it's not personal, they're stealing your dreams. If it's not personal, they're stealing your money. If it's not personal, they're stealing your position. If it's not personal, they're stealing your spirit. If it's not personal, they're shaking your soul. If it's not personal, they're taking you to church. If it's not personal, they're making you sick. If it's not personal, they're stressing you out. If it's not personal, they're breaking down your life. If it ain't personal, you ain't standing right. If it ain't personal, you ain't standing for God. If it ain't personal, you God in vain. It's got to be personal, church. It's got to be personal. Not no black history, my history. If you ain't got no history, you susceptible to fall. Breaking away from them generational curses. It's time that it stops today. No longer shall I be bound by what another man said about me. I'm going to make my history. I'm going to speak to God and let him break these curses. In the name of Jesus, let us pray. Father God, today is a day that you made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. God, I know that some people out there are just going through. We all going through something, God. We all need you one for another. God, one may need you for one thing. One might need you for another. But God, we're going through today. But you didn't allow us to come to this point, God, to give up now. I can't give up, God, because you're too good, God. Right now, God, I pray in the name of Jesus that you're already working it out. That you're already stirring it up. That you're already tearing down walls, God, destroying yokes, God. Right now, in the name of Jesus, you're bringing your church back together, Jesus. And we're not worried about no virus. We're going to be everything that we need to be in you, God. You're going to line it up, God, that no disease will come through the threshold of that door, God. In the name of Jesus, I bind it right now in Jesus' name. God, I pray for our family members. I pray for the sick and shut in right now, God. I pray for those who are stuck behind prison bars, God. I pray for those who just don't feel like they're capable of doing it any longer. I pray for those, God, who are bound to the things of this world. I pray to them, God, who are stuck in the generational curses. But God, in the name of Jesus, We come down, we declare and decree that every curse that our generation behold for us, man, God, and every sin that we've committed, God, that it is forgiven in the name of Jesus, God. Right now that you are already moving, declaring, decreeing, God, that it's already there to set us free. And God, your word says, who the Son set free is free indeed. But God, I stop now. I stop now. And I tell the church, tell God, release. My God. God, release this bondage, God. Release this addiction, God. Release this suicidal spirit, God. Release this unforgiving spirit, God. Release sickness, God. Release affliction, God. Release anything that hinders me, God. Let me have my mind back, God. That I might praise you and lift you up. Oh, God, we give you glory today. This ain't 1 month, God. This is every day. This is my history. And I'm a black man. But I stand in the name of Jesus. I stand in the name of Jesus. Jesus, when the winds and the waves cut up on the boat, and the disciples were in fear like we are sometimes about this virus, you stood up, God, and you said, peace. Be still. In Jesus' name, I speak it over your life. Whatever it is, whatever storm is raised, I say, peace. Be still in Jesus' name. And it is so, God, so it was good. And he put his favor on. And it is so, God, so it was good. And it is so, God, so it was good. You got to touch and agree. And it is so, God, so it was good. And his answer is yea and amen. His answer is yea and amen. His answer is yea and amen. In Jesus' name. Set them free, God. Let them know that you are the way. You are the truth and you are the life, God. God, I know that the Holy Spirit is moving right now in this place. Have your way in this place, God. That they won't be the same, God. Those curses that bind them down and have them back, God. Let them know that you already bind it up in their set. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
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 We have a little bit left on the ceremony. There'll be some presentations, so be patient with us briefly, and we'll be out of your way shortly. Just bear with us briefly. We just have a few presentations.
Choose the winner for answering the questions.
Dang. And the winner is Johnny Brown. Congratulations.
What's that, Deacon Brown?
I think Johnny Brown, she won't ask the question.
Amen. Amen.
Great honor to represent our elementary, middle school, and high school students and pre-K students to let them know that we are proud of you here at Mount Zion. And today, as Pastor Stokes has said, you are making history.
Amen.
Because of your academic achievement. It takes a lot, and now we're doing virtual and face-to-face. Some of us, we know it's hard at times. We got students that are failing because they are not used to being at home and they don't want to do what they have to do. But you prevail and you've done the things that you have to do. So at this time, we want to recognize you. And Kimberly, the youth president, or vice president, is coming up to help us to do this. Amen. And we want to say thanks again to the parents for your achievements, that you back your students. you know, Dr. King, they asked him down in front of the Capitol, how long? They asked how long? He said, not long.
Amen.
How long?
Not long.
How long?
Not long.
Okay, so here we are today recognizing our academic achievement. At this time, Kimberly's going to call your name. You'll come up and get it.
Ariana. Joy.
Amen.
Our future teacher.
Winter.
The sky's the limit.
Amen.
This is our kindergarten and pre-K. Let's give them a big hand of applause.
Next we have Canaria.
This is our elementary. Third grade, Forest Avenue. Let's give her a big hand of applause.
Good job. Shoot
it now.
Destiny.
Destiny is one of our middle school students, and we're very proud of you, Destiny.
And Makaya.
Last but not least, this is the pride of the package. Our high school students, you know, one 11th grader, one 12th grader, and we are so proud of you that you prevailed. Mm-hmm. You're at home doing virtual, one of you, what, you're at school? No, you're vocal virtual. Mm-hmm. And so we have students that in high school that are failing, that I talk to some parents, they're failing, they get back in bed when the parents leave home, but you prevail and you've done what you had to do. So at this time,
yeah, Denadia.
Amen.
And Mark.
And Mark. We call him
better known as school.
We are so proud of you. Leave our president, our youth department out. You got something you'd like to say to him?
No.
Not this time, okay.
Amen.
Okay. Now we're also blessed not only to have pre-K, elementary, middle school, and high school, but we also have some college students here.
Amen.
And we are so proud of our family. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. And this is the Anita Howard Educational Scholarship. Amen. It's an annual scholarship that we also give to our college students. It was in lieu of Anita Howard, who was a member here who was a divine member here. She was family here. Her sisters are still here. Her husband and children are still here. But I'm standing in on their behalf today. But the love is still here. She's big in this church here. Amen? Amen? Amen. Amen. So we would be remiss not to give a scholarship in her honor because she worked so diligently for these students, for this church,
amen,
and for her family. Amen?
Amen?
The first recipient of the Anita Howard Educational Scholarship is none other than Dakala DeJohnette. And she is a sophomore now at the UAB University in Birmingham, University of Alabama, Birmingham. Amen. We're proud of her. She makes me feel 6'3". Now, I'm glad that he's not actually here, because I'm saying 6'3", and he is 6'3". But our next recipient is Jamaica Washington. We're proud of him as well. He's a student of South University in Mobile. But his sister is standing in the gap for him right now. And we're proud of you, too. Jamaica, is he still on screen? Okay, we're proud of you too. Jamaica, would you like to say anything?
Yes, I'm sorry that I'm not there. I'm in Mobile right now. I wish I could be there in person, but I want to say thank you to the church and to the pastor. I'm very grateful.
Amen. We're so proud of you all. And I'm glad you're in Mobile right now too, because I'm the tallest one in the church. Amen, amen. God bless you all. We are so thankful. Are there any other presentations? No, I think that will do it. But I just want to say thank you to the committee, the scholarship committee. I want to say thank you for the committee that put the program together. It is beautiful how God is still working in the midst of a pandemic. President, would you like to have a word?
Just thank you all for being here and your support. And switching gears, as the secretary, just be ready at 7 o'clock tonight.
Amen. 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 Would you, youth advisors, would you have like to have a word, Kimberly? Justin?
Any other time, I'm the quiet one. I guess I'm talking today.
Amen.
But just thank you to the parents and the kids for coming out and allowing them to still be here and participate in church at this during this time. So we really appreciate it and thank you.
Well, thank you.
Amen. 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 I want to, anyone else? Ms. Kathy? Okay. Dee? Okay. I want to commend the church for the work that we're doing through the midst of this pandemic.
Amen.
The church is still thriving. I know some churches that are closed down. But we're not gonna let those generational curses stop this church.
Amen.
We're going to keep on fighting. We're going to keep on plugging. And I want to thank you all that are bold enough to be on screen and that are bold enough to come here in person. Because God has us all covered. Amen?
Amen?
It's not easy doing the work that God wants us to do, but it's worth it in the long run. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. So in every other church that joined us today, we want to say thank you. Everyone who came to visit with us today, we want to say thank you. Amen?
Amen.
Am I forgetting anything, First Lady?
No, sir.
Okay, because I know I'll get it later. I want to recognize.
I would say thank you to Brother Tommy Simmons for
Yes. For the churches around that are scared to go in, we're not, because we had a blessing yesterday. Brother Tommy Simmons came in and sanitized the church from top to bottom.
Yeah.
He sprayed it, he fogged it, but you still have to be obedient, wear our mask, and take every other precaution. But we're so thankful that the gifts will make way for the blessing.
Yeah.
So, Brother Simmons, I thank God for you.
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen?
Amen. And we're going to continue to do what we got to do to make sure that we are safe, socially distance, sanitize, and keep our mask on. So with that being said, we have some food in the back for those who are here, that we're going to break bread. And if I'm forgetting anything, tonight, 7 o'clock, be on Zoom. And don't forget, we have to be on Zoom at 7 o'clock. Let us pray. Father God, we just thank you for this message today. We thank you for Sunday school. We thank you for the program today. We thank you for every committee that was joined. We thank you for every heart and mind that is on the screen today. We thank you for, God, everybody who came out, God, to weather the storms of life, to know that these generational curses have to stop today. God, it ain't about black history, it's about my history. Yes. And I am history, God. And in the beginning, God, it's going to be a number. At the end, that's going to be a number. And in the middle, it's going to be a dash. I want it to be well done in the middle of my dash. I thank God for what we're doing today. I ask God to continue to bless, nurture, restroom, and abide with each one of us, God. Bless the food, the preparers of the food in the back, God. But bless us, God, that we can come back together one more time and all get together in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name I pray, let us all on one accord say, amen. 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 Amen.